some have asked me about some of the figures they saw me do in a previous video. So I want to talk to you a bit about left hand lead, or at least is how I got to it. I was deeply into Mahavishnu and Return to Forever in the 70s. And what I noticed, being right-handed, was that I could never quite approximate the sound of the hi-hat and the ghost notes. And I saw Billy the first time and figured left hand, oh, that's way too hard, left it alone. And in the fall of 79, when I was in Tokyo, I got to see Lenny White about 3 times in a month period. Got to hang out a bit, watch him at least twice in music store workshops. And figured, you know, that's how he gets his ghost note sound. And I had just gotten the theme from the Astral Pirates album. There's a song on there called Assault that goes da 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 ba 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 ba. And the way I heard it, I mean, the bass drum is. Two and four in the snare drum. And I heard it with quarter notes in the bass drum. So I figured I'd try it like this. And by the way, I'm sitting up pretty high now. Okay, that wasn't that hard. So from there, I went to eighth notes. Hi-hat with the shoulder of the stick toward the edge, as opposed to this way, which I might do if I was playing right-handed. So, I mean, it's going to sound differently right-handed. Listen to this. I can approximate it left-handed, but it's more natural for me to hit it this way. So I'm going to get a different sound. I'm going to get a different sound this way. Naturally. And certain things are easier for me to draw out of the drum this way than this way. It may not look that way now, but if you try it and work it out, you'll see certain things naturally happen more easily than others. Anyway, so it's easy to get from there, from quarter notes to eighth notes. And once I could get to eighth notes, closing the hi-hat on, say, 1 and 3. So you can start playing with barking possibilities. On a related note, Rayford Griffin, who also plays leads left-handed, did a thing with Jean-Luc Ponty, which I think you can check on the live Montreal Jazz Festival clip he did, in which he went like that. That was real cool. It's not something I would have stumbled into leading right. Anyway, so we're there. We got the eighth notes. We got the quarter notes. Once you have the eighth note thing down, it's a pretty simple matter if you're playing anything samba related. And of course, we North Americans were all busy trying to get the beginnings of the Afro-Cuban thing and the Brazilian thing down back then. So, from, you know, here. Stuff, because it's really because you're going this way, it's less fussy than if you're going around this way. And of course, you can go. Then it's not a leap, not much of a leap to go to kind of a mid-tempo swing thing. Faster playing right-handed than I am left-handed. If I'm doing impressions at 400 a minute, 400 beats per minute, it's going to be over here. But for a lot of the mid-tempo stuff and the rock stuff and the funk stuff, I can deal with it here, which gives me a lot more freedom here in terms of power, because you can hit a backbeat a lot, much more power here than you can this way. So it's just something to think about. What else can I talk about?